Welcome everyone to our new IoT tutorial, and in this tutorial we are going to discuss Node-RED management dashboard. And in this session we are going to set up this Mosquito MQTT broker on our Raspberry Pi, and also we are going to set up this Node-RED on Raspberry Pi, and we will be sending data from the sensors which are connected to NodeMCU ESP8266 module, and we will be visualizing these data on the Node-RED dashboard. And the same in reverse manner, we are also going to send data from the Node-RED MQTT client, and the same will be performed by the servo motor and the built-in LED of NodeMCU. So the next slide is the video map. That this video will be divided into 5 parts. In the first part, we are going to see the demo and understand how this project is working. The third part is the circuit diagram, and architecture explanation is the fourth part. And lastly, we are going to explain our code, which we have written in Arduino for sending data from NodeMCU. And in case of Raspberry Pi, we used some JavaScript code in Node-RED, so that we can get those data and parse those data into correct format. So this is the Node-RED dashboard, and in this first section we are seeing this LDR data, the brightness data, which is coming from the LDR sensor, right, from this sensor. And the second one is this humidity data and temperature data, which is coming from DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor, this one. And we are also going to control the switch in real time. Let's control the built-in LED of this NodeMCU. Let's turn it on. You can see in the demo that the LED is turned on, and we can also turn it off. And the gauge brightness is right now 344. Okay, so if I move my hand above the sensor, the brightness will decrease above it, and we can see in the dashboard that it is right now 243, 198. It is decreasing, and it's decreased by 100. Okay, 307 to 198. Okay, and you can also see that this history chart, which is showing data of 2 minutes. 2 minute data is seen here by line chart, and the temperature data is around 22.7, 22.8, 23.5, 22.8. Okay, it is varying between 22 and 23, 24 basically. So, and the humidity is around 77, 78. Fine, let's control the servo motor position. Let's make it okay. So if we can see the serial monitor of the Arduino, that the data which we are sending here, like you can see that movement in the servo motor. And we have set this dashboard in such manner that it will send data from this switch and servo position slider, and receive data on this gauge and this line chart, this chart. So this is the dashboard we are creating in this session. So the requirements of this project are Raspberry Pi, Mosquito MQTT broker, Node-RED. And Mosquito MQTT broker and Node-RED, these two softwares need to install on a Raspberry Pi. And it is not compulsory that you have to use the Raspberry Pi. You can also use your system, your computer, for the same purpose. And for the sensor part, you must have this ESP8266 or any other Wi-Fi module. And these sensors which I am using here is this LDR resistor, and the DHT11 temperature sensor, and a servo motor. In the circuit diagram of this project, we can see the NodeMCU is connected with this LDR sensor through this 10k ohm resistor, and this A0, which is the only pin of and only analog pin of NodeMCU is connected, and it is getting the analog data from this analog sensor, which is the LDR sensor. And this second thing is the DHT11 digital sensor, which is using a digital pin D1, the 3-pin sensor it is, and one rail of it is connected to 3.3 volt and the other rail is connected to the ground. And this servo motor is similarly, the control pin of servo motor is connected to pin D8. And this is the whole circuit diagram of this project. So now let's discuss the Arduino sketch. And in the first part, we can see here that we are importing the libraries, the important libraries, and we have initialized the variables, like DHT11 sensor is initialized to pin D1. The SSID password is the Wi-Fi name and password, which we will later use in this sketch, in the setup method basically. And this LED pin, which is D0 active low pin, and we can directly see here from the setup method that we are going to connect with the NodeMCU to the Wi-Fi through this line. And after that, we are initializing the LED as output. This pin is output, and we are setting the pin as high initially, which means that it will be in off state because it is active low. Then we are DHT.begin method, which will initialize the library, DHT library. The myservo.attach D8, which will attach this pin D8 to the servo object, which we have defined in the above part right here. Servo, myservo. So this will attach this that pin, initialize that pin. And after that, we are connecting to this IP address. So this is one important thing, that this IP address should be in the Wi-Fi network, should be in the Wi-Fi network of your Raspberry Pi as well as of your NodeMCU. This is the IP address of the Raspberry Pi basically. So you will get this IP address from the SSH by simply using this command host name minus I, and you can easily get here 192.168.0.196, and net it will be connected to 1883 port, which we have already seen that we are setting up this Mosquito MQTT broker on the same port. And client.on message method will be message received if we receive any message on the subscribe topics. After we connect, we will be subscribing to these two topics, NodeMCU/LED, NodeMCU/servo. And if we receive any messages on these two topics, we can easily perform action, like we are performing action for LED and for servo. So for LED, if we are receiving the payload of ON on, we will be making it low, which will basically turn the LED on, D0 pin on, and else it will be high. And for the servo, we are basically writing the servo pin to that position. Basically, we are moving the servo to that degree, and we are basically sending here 0 to 180. Fine. And so let's discuss the loop part. We are connecting to the MQTT broker of Raspberry Pi with this IP address, so that we can now publish a message roughly every 5 seconds. Okay, so we are publishing here LDR message, the message brightness message, by reading the A0 pin, analog pin A0, and read humidity and read temperature. These two methods are provided by this library for reading the humidity and temperature. So we need to just check that these two must not be not a number NAN, must not be NAN, and if it is not, format we are sending here it as a JSON string, so that we can easily parse it at Node-RED end. So now let's discuss the architecture of this project, and we will be creating the Node-RED dashboard parallelly this flow. We have already created this flow, but for your more understanding, I will be creating this flow with this architecture parallelly. So Raspberry Pi is the on Raspberry Pi we are, our MQTT broker is running, and what we are doing here is, from one client we are sending data, and from another client we are subscribing the same topic and we are getting that data. So in MQTT architecture, we have the concepts of publish and subscription. So we need to basically subscribe for a topic on which we want to receive the data. and some other client, someone from other client who will know this topic name, this one can easily send data and we will receive that. So our only work is to subscribe the topic on which we want to need the data, on which we want to receive the data. And if you want to publish some data on one topic, another client, like in this case NodeMCU is one client and Node-RED is another client. So NodeMCU, if you NodeMCU want to receive some data, Node-RED will publish it on, and the topics would be common, like LED, and NodeMCU/LED is the common topic and Node-RED is publishing the data. And here this LED of NodeMCU, which is on one pin, is receiving the data and performing the action. So let's create a switch here, and you will not find that this, if you don't find this dashboard on this section, on this left sidebar, you can easily get it from this manage palette section and search for install and go for dashboard. Okay, so in dashboard you can find Node-RED dashboard is already installed in my case, but you need to install it to get this section, so that these widgets will be already only in this package. So in switch we are going to publish data, so you need MQTT publish node. So here it says connect to MQTT broker and publish message, so click on it and go there and simply connect it. Okay, so in this flow we can see that we need to just the groups are already there, but in your case there will be no group, so you need to add new group and click on it. So the names of groups will be anything you want. You can name it like for this case I will name it switch, you don't have any tab, so let me add a new tab. Let's name it test, and the icon, this icon name is basically the icon name of this library, Google Material Design icon. So you can easily search for that and you can name the icon specifically according to your requirement. Fine. So the tab is test tab, name is switch, and the width is 6. Fine. So click on add, and this switch will be sending on true and false, but we will already shown in the Arduino sketch that we are expecting on and off on these two topics. We are expecting payload of on if we want to turn on the LED, and payload of anything other than that to make it off. So we need to send here a string value and make it on, and also make it anything other than it, you can off or any other thing. And simply click on done button, and as you click on this, MQTT broker will receive that data on that topic. And if another client want that data, they can subscribe to that topic. Like in this case, this NodeMCU is subscribe to this topic LED, NodeMCU/LED. Okay, so we haven't configured this one. Okay, so you have to configure this one. You have to connect with your broker. Like in my case, you don't have my broker, but you need to add one in your case. So let's make it test broker, and the server name should be the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. Okay, so in my case the IP address is 192.168.0.196. 192, and the default port is 1883 for MQTT over TCP. And we will discuss the whole architecture of MQTT, that it can be used over SSL, over other things, but currently we are using the basic one, the 1883, the default port. And simply client ID, if you leave it as blank, it will be auto generated. Fine. So click on this add button. Test broker is added. Now the topic must be on which topic we want to send the data, NodeMCU/LED, so that we can receive it on, we can easily receive it on the NodeMCU and NodeMCU/LED. Name can be anything, you can leave it as blank. Then NodeMCU/LED is created here, and we need to click on this deploy button. Okay, so here we can see a small thing called connected. Fine, so if you want to see this flow dashboard, this dashboard of this flow, you can easily show that using this this thing, Raspberry Pi dot local, or the IP address, anything you want, or /UI. So you know, this is the NodeMCU thing which I have shown you for demo, but what we have created here is test. You can see the switch here, and you are sending and receiving data. And if you want to know that it is received or not, you can easily check, you can easily subscribe to the this topic on any other client other than this NodeMCU. You can also use a third client, so I can use any other third client. So for this purpose of testing, I can use MQTT box, which is another client. So simply you need to create MQTT client, and after while creating it, you can easily host name, the Raspberry Pi IP address and port number. Okay, and you are connected with the IP address. So NodeMCU/LED, subscribe it here, and you can publish data from this sketch. You can easily publish data. And we can see that published data will be received like here. If we click on this plus button, you can see that one message received here. Fine. And if we turn it off, the off message will be received here. So this is how this thing works, the NodeMCU client and publish subscription methods is working here. So apart from it, we have other things like gauge. We have this chart. Let's add a gauge and add a chart. Okay, so you can add a gauge easily. You can go to the dashboard section and you can search for gauge. So here gauge, we want to send data here. In this case, we want to send data. Okay, so we can easily use this MQTT input method, which will connect to the MQTT broker and subscribes to message for a specified topic. So we just need to define the topic here, topic. So this is the test broker, the same broker you have created. You need to add the topic. So we want to receive data from which topics. The LDR data is coming on NodeMCU/LDR. Okay, so just type here NodeMCU/LDR and quality of service. This is QoS, quality of service. We can discuss this thing in a separate tutorial. So done. And gauge data, the value which will vary from 0 to the LDR data. In here, in my case, it is varies from 600, 0 to 600. And simply connect it and deploy it. And now, if you move to the test tab, NodeMCU/LDR. So you have to select the correct group which you want to use. So I have created this switch group for test, so you need to select the same, because it will add only if you have, you will be selecting the same group. So done and deploy. And if you move to test, you can see the switch as well as gauge, which is 440 right now, and it will vary if I, it will vary real time, 382. So this is how this gauge thing works. Now let's add a chart, and now let's use the this data. Let's use the data of this NodeMCU/DHT, this JSON formatted data, that how we will be consuming this data. Fine. So we will be consuming this data, this JSON string. We need to parse it. Okay. So we can also use this thing. Let's convert between JSON string and its JSON object representation. But I am using another thing, which is function. This node, this is very helpful node. If you are familiar with JavaScript, you can easily use this thing. Okay. So we need a chart to display the data. So here we can find the chart. So here the chart is right button, text chart. Okay. So here is the chart, and we are we need to get data here. So we need to subscribe it. Someone is publishing it. What we need to do here is just subscribe it. This thing is publishing it. NodeMCU is publishing it, this data in this format. We need to subscribe it to show it like in this. So this the same thing. Just we need to name the topic as NodeMCU/DHT. Okay. So this, and the broker is test broker, and if we want to know that what is the data which we are receiving here from this topic, we can use this debug node and deploy it. And you can see that 23.40.78.00, this is the for data which we are receiving, and we want to first parse it. So you can easily write a function here, like we want to parse it. So you know, you are familiar with a function called json.parse, and it will receive it. Inside it we will parse the JSON string. So here the JSON string will be message.payload. Fine. And this message should be returned, the value should be returned in payload, in the payload variable. So in the message.payload, you can easily send that value which you want to send. So I want to send the temperature value, object of dot temp, this value. First we parse it, then we search for it, and we message in the message.payload, we will send the object dot temp. And after we click on done, this is done. We need to click this flow in this manner. And if you want to see the message payload, delete this sketch, and for the chart, select this test switch which we have created, and this chart. And you can see that x-axis is 1 hour data, is last 1 hour data. You can minimize it to 3 minute, 2 minute, or 5 minute to make it more to make it more better. So you can see that after I click on deploy, 23.8, this temperature is now formatted in this format, 23.8, 24.3. okay. And let's see that what is going on the test tab. You can see that this data is coming, and we can see that it is getting this chart in this format. Fine. So I think this flow is completed right here. So that's all for this video. You can like, share, and subscribe for more videos like this. And if you have any idea, join us to collaborate, or if you want to develop any IoT based project, please contact us. Thank you.